10th class students, assalamu alaikum. Unit number 1, exercise number 1.2, the remaining questions. So question number 1, solve the following equations using quadratic formula. So this type of questions we have done already in last lecture. Now today this equation is given, quadratic equation, but we have to arrange it. So firstly x square, then x, and then constant equal to 0. Constant is on the right side, we have to take it on the left side in this equation. So after arranging means 3 x square plus x minus 4, because if it will be moved on the left hand side, so its sign will be changed. Minus 4 square root 3 is equal to 0. This is our first equation. Now we will compare it by standard form of quadratic equation, that is, as you know, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Here a is equal to, as ax square, a is equal to square root 3, square root 3, b is equal to, there is no any coefficient with x, so that's why it will be 1, b is equal to 1, and c is equal to minus 4 square root 3. So this is a value, b value, and c values we have found. Now you know students, by quadratic formula, what is quadratic formula? Quadratic formula is x is equal to minus b plus minus square root b square minus 4ac by 2a. We will place the values which we have found here from this quadratic equation. So placing the values, what is b value? B value is minus 1 plus minus 1 whole square minus 4. A value is square root 3, and c value is minus 4 square root 3 over 2, and a value is square root 3. We have placed these values, now we will solve it. This will be minus 1 as it is, plus minus square root 1, minus minus plus 4 times 16, because there is no sign between them, that's why both will be multiplied to each other. So square root 3 will be multiplied with square root 3, so it will be 3. Means it will be in this way, and square will be cancelled with square root, divided by 2 into square root 3 as it is, minus 1 plus minus 1 minus 16 multiplied by 3 over 2 square root 3. So x is equal to minus 1 plus minus 16, 3 times is 48, sorry, it's positive sign, it's 48 by 2 into square root 3, minus 1 plus minus 49 by 2 square root 3, So x is equal to minus 1 plus minus square root of 49 is 7 by 2 into square root 3. So we will take one time positive and one time negative. X is equal to minus 1 plus 7 by 2 into square root 3. And second time, x is equal to minus 1 minus 7 by 2 into square root 3. So x is equal to 6 by 2 into square root 3, means 2 3 times, and x is equal to minus 8 by, because minus minus plus, but sign is negative because both are negative, 2 square root 3, it will be cancelled 4 times, so x will be 3 by 3. And x is equal to minus 4 by square root 3. So how to solve it further? As you know students, it's square root 3. So if we will write it, because that is equal to, 3 is equal to square root 3 into square root 3. Because both will be, if both will be multiplied, so we will get square root 3. So why we can't write instead of 3, 2 times square root 3, because both are equal. There is no effect on this term. So 1 will be cut with it. It's simplification. X is equal to square root 3 and x is equal to minus 4 by 3. These two values we got, which is solution set is square root 3 and minus 4 by square root 3. This is our question number 1, part 3. Now move towards the next. Now students, part 7. 3 by x minus 6 minus 4 by x minus 5 is equal to 1. This is also with the same method. We have to solve it by using quadratic formula. But first of all, we will change in the form of quadratic equation in standard form first. 3 by x minus 6 minus 4 by x minus 5 is equal to 1. Students, what to do, because it's negative sign is between them, but on the sides, on the corners, there is fraction. So it's method to do, we have to take its LCM. On the left side, right side will be as it is. It will be equal to 1. Basically, we have taken LCM now. Students, its denominator will be cut with denominator, and what will be the left? 3. 3 will be multiplied with x minus 5. Now, its denominator will be cancelled with x minus 5, and 4 is left. 4 will be multiplied here. Denominator x minus 6 will be left with x minus 6. We will solve now. That is 3x minus 15 minus 4x minus minus plus 24 by, it will be also multiplied, means it will be x square minus 6x minus 5x minus minus plus 6 5 times 30 equal to 1. Here we have opened the brackets, both these we have multiplied, firstly x with x, x square, and then 6 with x minus 6x then first of all we have taken this value and multiplied with it, then we have taken 5. So the first with first, first with second, then second with first and second with second. Now it will be 5x and 5 6 times is 30. Now so we have to simplify it. After simplification, 3x minus 4x we will subtract, because both are x, so variables are same, we can subtract them both, but it can't be solved with these two because it's constant. These both can be solved and these both can be simplified. So we will perform a subtraction. Here it will be negative x, because greater value has negative sign. So plus minus minus, we got minus x, and plus minus minus, but sign will be positive because greater value has positive sign. These two will be added or subtracted. These two will be added or subtracted. It means variables coefficient, variable coefficient same, and constant will be solved. Plus 9 over, it will be also solved as x square minus minus plus, but sign will be negative because both have negative sign. That will be 11x minus 11x plus 30 equal to 1. Students, so now we will cross multiply it. Cross multiplication, it will be multiplied over there and it will be multiplied here. X square minus 11x plus 30 is equal to minus x plus 9. So x square minus 11x plus 30, we will shift it here, it's negative sign here, but when it will be moved on the other side, sign will be positive, plus x minus 9 is equal to 0. Now students, we will compare by the equation. Now solve it first. Okay, x square, this one can be solved here because both are xx variables. So plus minus minus, negative sign will be there because greater value has negative sign. It will be 10x plus minus minus 30 minus 20, 30 minus 9, that will be 21 is equal to 0. So this is our equation. Now as we were having in last questions quadratic equation in standard form, now we can compare it with general quadratic equation. That is, you know students, that is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So we have to compare. Now we will find the values of a, b and c. Here a is equal to 1 because there is no coefficient of x square, b is equal to minus 10 and c is equal to 21. Now by quadratic formula, what quadratic formula is there? X is equal to minus b plus minus square root b square minus 4ac by 2a. This is quadratic formula. We will place these values in formula now. Now students, we have placed the values of in quadratic formula which we were having a, b, c values. And 10 2 times 100, because that was negative sign, it will be positive now. Negative and negative, it will be positive now. 4 21 times is 84. Now it will be 10 plus minus 100 minus 84, it will be 16 by 2. X is equal to, it's 10 plus minus square root of 16 is 4 by 2. So that is plus positive negative ones we will take it positive and ones we will take it negative. So x is equal to 10 plus 4 by 2 and x is equal to 10 minus 4 by 2. So x is equal to 10 plus 4, it's 14 by 2. And x is equal to 10 minus 4, it's 6 by 2. 2 7 times, 2 3 times. So what x values we got? X is equal to 7 and x is equal to 3. This is our solution set. It's 3 and 7. Students, this is our question number 7 I have solved for you. Now all questions are with the same method. Means we have to just solve the equation. If that is not solved, if that is not in standard form, we have to make in standard form and then compare it with general form of quadratic equation, and then just quadratic formula we have to apply in all questions. Quadratic formula, after applying, we can write the values of ABC in quadratic formula and simplify it. Then it will be 2 times 1 positive 1 negative, x values we have found and solution set we got. This is today's lecture. We have solved 2 parts now. The remaining you will solve, students, question number 1 till part 8. 9 and 10 inshallah I'll solve. These are also very easy, but I will solve 9 and 10 for you. You will solve till 8 part. 7 I have solved today. You will complete till 8. Students, practice it frequently and solve on your register. I will check inshallah in next lecture. We will start part number 9 and 10. Till then, Allah Hafiz.